Ladies and gentlemen, lords and ladies, please provide a warm welcome for your tournament heralds, Mr. Tony Roberts and Mr. Brandon Zielinski.
Good morning, Dalton! Good morning, everyone. Who's awake out there? The judges are awake. That's good. All right, everyone else asleep? This side, absent, not present. That's okay. How about you guys? Are you awake?
Yeah!
All right, we are very excited to be here at the Peachtree District Qualifier Dalton event to play this year's game, First Stronghold. We have many teams here after some of our tournament riches, which we call awards.
There is one amazing twist this year, and that is where you become part of the game. Yes, you, the audience. You will select every couple of matches the fifth defense to be rotated in this spot right here. So, you will have more details on that later, but suffice to say, you'll have to make some noise.
All right, we got many veteran teams out there today. Let me hear you, veterans. All right, now who's a rookie out there? Who's our rookie teams? Woo! Make some noise, rookies. All right, we got many teams here from all over the great state of Georgia ready to play this game. But before we get going, we're gonna hear from the two guys that started the first program, Dean Kamen and Dr. Woody Flowers, along with the president of FIRST, Mr. Don Bosey.
Ready your champion, the quest is about to begin.
We hope you're all ready to show your strategy, creativity, and gracious professionalism. After six intense weeks, it's time to rally for First Stronghold.
Thank you to all the mentors, sponsors, suppliers, parents, and each of you for making this a great event and season. FIRST works because of your support and determination.
Building your robot was a team effort. And we can't wait to see over 3,000 unique robots developed to score well and succeed.
You're right, Woody, and the teams have already succeeded in many ways just by being here.
Over the next few days, you will learn even more about character and grit.
That's enough talking. Let's get this quest underway and prove why FIRST is so much more than just robots.
FIRST Stronghold, commence.
Thank you to Dean, Woody, and Don. Now I'd like to welcome our first distinguished guest of the day. He is the mayor pro tem of the great city of Dalton. Please welcome Mr. Tate O'Gwin.
I appreciate it. Welcome, everybody. We're glad you're here today. My name is Tate O'Gwin. I'm the mayor pro tem of the city of Dalton, and we're just glad that y'all are here walking around and seeing all the machines and everything is just incredibly impressive. Up here in Northwest Georgia, manufacturing is king. We know that the skills that y'all are developing through this competition are ones that'll hopefully lead to good jobs in the future. And we respect your hard work. And again, we're glad you're here. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Now, this event is only made possible with the great support that we have here from our local sponsors. From one of those great companies, please welcome Mr. Leslie Rush, the Chief Watershed Services Officer from Dalton Utilities.
Good morning. On behalf of Dalton Utilities, I welcome you to Dalton and to the competition. We're grateful that you're here. Obviously, we would like to see everybody win, but we hope that that you enjoy your experience. We're very proud to be a sponsor of the event. If you as a student can engage in science and engineering, Dalton is a very rich manufacturing town, and there's jobs available here. So good luck in the competition, and welcome.
Thank you, sir. Now, Dalton Utilities was not the only local sponsor to step up to make this event happen. Please welcome our next speaker, Mr. Brian Cooksey, the Director of Operations Training at Shaw Industry.
Good morning. Are there some robot teams in the house? Let me hear you. We are so honored to have you here in Dalton, Georgia. On behalf of the 23,000 Shaw Industries Associates worldwide, we are honored to be hosting this event in our beautiful Northwest Georgia community of Dalton. Shaw Industries makes floor covering, including the playing field that you're competing on today. Let's hear it for the flooring industry here. We use robotics every day in our industry, and we invite you to come by our booth and check out one of the industrial robots that we have on display. You'll see it playing putt-putt, but they do amazing things. The skills you're learning go right into our industry, and we hope you'll consider the flooring industry when you're looking for job opportunities, co-op opportunities, that type of thing when you go to college. Just want to make sure to put a plug in. You've heard it several times today, but we want you to come by and register for some iPads and some Beats headphones and have a lot of fun. We're here for you guys, and we want you to have a great time today, have a lot of fun, and let's do some great things. Good luck.
Thank you, sir. Now, the next speaker today partnered with Georgia First to also help bring this event to Dalton. Please welcome the president of Northwestern Technical College, Mr. Pete McDonald.
Good morning, everyone. I'm very excited to be here. I know the teams are excited, and they're probably a little nervous right now, but they will hit their stride soon. I just want to encourage all the team members and everyone that's here to continue to pursue your innovative thinking, your creativity, and as Brian mentioned, we need lots of creative minds in science and mathematics and industry in our nation. So I wish you the best today. I'm really excited to be here and look forward to the competition. Thank you very much.
Now, from our very valuable partnership with Georgia Power, who has supplied the awesome machine shop back in the pits, please welcome Mr. Randy Selby, Engineering Manager at Georgia Power here in Dalton.
Welcome, everybody, to Dalton. Like you said, my name is Randy Selby. I'm over the engineering group here in Dalton with Georgia Power. Most of you know Georgia Power is the largest utility in the state of Georgia, and as part of Southern Company, one of the largest in the country. Hopefully, you have had the opportunity to utilize the machine shop and spare parts. I've seen a constant line there, so hopefully that's been beneficial. We're here to capture the most powerful thing in this room, and that's your mind. Your creativity, your innovation, your thirst for a better future. So there are plenty of opportunities in the utility industry. We're glad to have you here. Take this opportunity. These skill sets are things that will pay well in the future. If you're like me, you're one of those that took stuff apart just to figure out how it worked. So we're glad to have you here. Best wishes to each of you, and have a good day. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now, our next guest is the president of and CEO of the Greater Dalton Chamber of Commerce. Please welcome Mr. Rob Bradham.
Good morning. How is everybody this morning? Awesome. That's great. Welcome to Dalton. I cannot tell you how proud we are to host you all here in the great city of Dalton. As several other speakers have mentioned, we have a huge manufacturing base here in Dalton, and we need people just like you to come and work in that manufacturing base. I've got two pieces of good news for you. The first one is I'm the last speaker before we get to what we need to do today. And the second one is I had this really long speech that I'm just going to throw out. I was going to tell you about all the skills that you're going to learn today through this process. I'm just going to tell you to have fun, because at the end of the day, that's what today is all about, having fun and competing. Best of luck to all of you, but especially to my fighting mongooses. Where are my fighting mongooses? Right over here. Go Career Academy. Thank you all for being in Dalton. I hope you enjoy your time here, and we're very proud to have you. Good luck today.
Thank you. All right, now let's start to meet some of the groups of volunteers that make today possible. First of all, starting with those volunteers in the blue shirts down here. To meet our esteemed panel of judges, please welcome Judge Advisor Chip McDaniel from Automation Direct.
Hello, teams. So glad you're all here. I want to quickly introduce the folks in the blue shirts. They're going to be coming around talking to you in your pits today. When you have time, please feel free to let them know if you're about to go to a match that they need to come back and see you a little bit later. But before I get to my judges, I want to introduce Debbie Kaufman. If you guys could stand as I mention your names. Debbie is our judge assistant. We could not do this without Debbie. She makes it all work. Debbie, in her spare time, is also the outreach mentor for Walton Robotics Community and is also on the Cobb STEM board member as well. Thank you very much, Debbie. All right, as mentioned, I guess I'm next on this list here. I'm Chip McDaniel. I'm technical marketing with Automation Direct. And then, thank you much. Sue Miller, business analyst of the Coca-Cola Company. Jeffrey Keith, operations management at Shaw Industries. Julie Kelly, operations management at Shaw Industries. Patrick Spence, operations management at Shaw Industries. Haley Cox, operations management at Shaw Industries. Randy Graff, operations management at Shaw Industries. Is there some Shaw Industries in the house today? We got Greg Higdon, guess what? Operations management at Shaw Industries. And one more, Justin Johnson, operations management at Shaw Industries. And then we also have a couple of others. Let's see, Matt Sosaby is an instructor at Northwestern Technical College. He's industrial systems technology. We have also Cody Brewer, the instrumentation instructor at Georgia Northwestern Technical College. And last but not least, my good friend, Scott Lee. He's a collaborations product specialist with Cisco. Thanks very much, have fun.
All right, we have the entire operations management group from Shaw Industries here today.
Thank you, Mr. McDaniel, and also thank you to the rest of the judges for all of your time and efforts. I'm sure you'll have a very, very difficult job this weekend. Now, another group of volunteers you'll get to know over the course of this weekend is the referees. Their job is to ensure fair play and to ensure everyone competes well and with gracious professionalism throughout the entire weekend. Now, the rulings will be final, and there will be no video replays. With that said, can I please introduce Mr. Greg Welsh, our head referee.
Good morning. Y'all ready to robot? All right. We got a good seasoned crew here. We did Columbus last weekend. It's a fun game. We're going to have a good time. Let me introduce our other ones. Zach Bunning, Dungeon Master, and science teacher at South Forsyth Middle School. Bert Adams, retired NCR engineer. Jonathan Welsh, first astronaut to step on the sun. Science and technology teacher at North Forsyth Middle School. Matt Swafford, inventor of the barrel roll. He's a rehab tech. Damian Abel, financial analysis manager at Coca-Cola. And Matthew Johnson, he is a career couch potato and a student researcher for Georgia Tech. Thank you very much. Let's have fun.
All right, in addition to fair play here on the field, another priority at first is safety. You can have fun and be safe at the same time. Now, please welcome our lead safety advisor, Logan Liu from Underwriters Laboratories and the UL Safety Advisors. Now, congratulations to Team 846, the Funky Monkeys from San Jose, California, and their terrific award-winning safety animation. Let's check it out. Thank you.
comes first. Wear your safety glasses, wear your closed-toed shoes, else you ain't getting past us. Can't be in the hoodie business, gotta tie the hair down as if you wanna keep it. You can have a safe time like this. If you drop it, pick it up just like this. What? Couple screws and some ties, all those chips, that's a risk. Something worth an extra second in the pits, yeah. Tech inspector straight, never waste that. No running while you're trying to get to a match. Bring the bot in, give me space, man. Batteries charging, you should watch that. Working safety with your robot.
Great job to them. Now, also speaking of safety, make sure you all have a safety plan. If you mentors, if you please communicate with your teams where to meet in case of an evacuation, and also whatever else you want your team to do. Also, note the exits in the arena and in the pits. Turn around, they might be behind you. Insert the small metal flap into the buckle. You know the deal. In an emergency, please listen to field and pit instructions for any additional information that we may need to provide to you. Thank you.
All right, now students, we know that you're not just learning engineering and computer skills in FIRST. You're also learning business skills and 21st century life skills. Now, colleges and universities recognize these skills that you're learning, and they want you. Each year, hundreds of colleges and universities make available millions of dollars in scholarships to you as part of a FIRST program. Now, to hear from some FIRST alumni who are benefiting from these scholarships, let's check out their video.
There are lots of great reasons to be on a FIRST team, but there's one fun, free, and important benefit we want to make sure that you take advantage of: the FIRST Scholarship Program. The costs of higher education are rising every year, whether you choose a 2 or a 4-year education. FIRST Scholarship Program is a partnership between FIRST and colleges and universities who are making available over $22 million in scholarships to you. We know that planning for your future can be intimidating, so we video chatted with a few FIRST alumni to talk about their experiences and what they wish they knew when they were sitting where you are.
Without the scholarship that I received, I couldn't have done everything that I've done. And by having that money that I got, it changed my life. It brought me to where I am today, and I'm so thankful for it.
I saw the program, and I was so excited to apply. And if not for the FIRST scholarship program, I wouldn't be where I am today.
There's tons of scholarships out there that are available on the website that are for non-engineering majors also. And if you do plan on going into engineering, they look for people like you, people like who have been involved in FIRST, have experiences one-on-one hand with, you know, working with engineers.
Apply, because if you don't apply, you won't get it.
If I would have stuck with football instead of working with FIRST, I wouldn't be where I am today. FIRST helped develop my work ethic. It developed my communication skills. It developed my business skills, my building skills. It developed my reasons of how to deal with others in life and in my own community. And then it also gave me a chance to give back to my community. That's nothing that really I would have got to do by playing football.
Everyone should apply. It doesn't take that much time to fill out the applications, and you lose absolutely nothing by filling it out and sending it in.
Being an immigrant myself, it wasn't really an option. My parents instilled in me, and my teachers really instilled in me, that I should definitely go to college. My parents did not have the opportunity to go to college, so it was a very big deal that I go to college.
There you have it. The FIRST Scholarship Program has consistently made an impact on the lives and futures of FIRST participants. FIRST Tech Challenge and FIRST Robotics Competition participants are all eligible to apply. Seniors, make sure that you're applying now. Many deadlines fall within the build and competition seasons, so check out the site today. You freshmen, sophomores, and juniors, go see what colleges and universities are making available, because it can help with your college search to come. You don't want to miss out on these great opportunities.
Remember, apply, apply, apply for those FIRST scholarships. Now, in the FIRST Kingdom, we only give out one individual award to students, and that is the Dean's List Award. Can students who are nominated by their teams as Dean List semifinalists, can you please stand up and be recognized? Now, good luck in your interviews.
All right, now, mentors and coaches out there, we know that you are critical to the first experience, and we also know that you mentor other teams from the first progression of programs, whether it's JFLL, FLL, or the First Tech Challenge in addition to FRC. We want to thank you for all your dedication and efforts throughout the season and the off-season. You really proved that FIRST is more than robots. Let's hear it for your mentors and coaches. Now, remember that FIRST will meet you where you are, no matter your age or abilities or skills, so be sure to check out firstinspires.org to find a program that fits you.
Wonderful. Now, before we get the robots into action, can we please rise for the National Anthem of the United States, performed by Mrs. Laura Kate Wright of Dalton High School, and the presentation of the colors by the Dalton High School JROTC under the direction of Dr. First Sergeant Jackson.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets regular, the bonds bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet
play First Stronghold? All right, now, everyone knows that an important part of a first competition is practice, practice, practice. And we want to make sure that you guys have a chance to practice on your teams with your robots to perfect your strategy out here. We'll get a chance for our field stewards to come out and perfect their movement of these defenses, and our cue is to perfect moving the teams on and off the field safely and quickly. So we will be having practice matches beginning as soon as we can get six robots on this field, and that will continue until about 12 o'clock for lunch. We will come back at 1 o'clock to begin our qualification rounds, which will go till 6 o'clock tonight, but the pits will stay open until 8 o'clock so you guys can continue to work on your robots. So for now, we're going to get practice teams onto the field, and we're going to begin our first set of practice matches. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, we're going to get ready to get started with these practice matches, but what we're going to do is we'll announce the team numbers and maybe the team names that are out there, and we will try to work on some sound levels and stuff while we're getting ready for lunch in between. So just be patient with us as we work through any technical difficulties that we might have. As we work with the announcers, get the announcers and the MCs, everybody together. Got a lot going on today. Appreciate your assistance.
Hello, 1, 2. One, two, three, nothing. Nothing's coming. Testing, 1, 2. Testing, 1, 2. You hearing it? Two.